The fact is, though, the AFC's always been horrible. We got a question. Larry?
Are there any more wings?
I don't know. Check in the back there. We got free wings down here at the Hey, if you're watching us on BTV and you're flipping around, you know, don't watch your TV. Come down here and talk to us, you know. Everybody's having a good time. We're watching the Cowboys romp the Eagles. There's some free wings. There's a little cover charge to get in, but probably not in a little while because, you know, we're more than halfway through here. I can't see the TV, but that's all right.
If I could take a moment here, two quick things. One, I want to give a shout-out to everybody up in Fillmore.
Fillmore 204, what's going on in 101?
101. And also, I met another crazy Jet fan here named Adam. If he can run up here real quick. He's got the motto for all Jet fans this season.
Yeah, bring that paper bag up here. This is what you Jet fans have been reduced to.
It just about says it all.
The paper bag tradition started with the Aints in New Orleans back in the 70s and 80s.
The acronym.
And now the Jets have taken it on right here. That's a beautiful thing. Did you make this for the show?
Yeah, we did. I just have a question for you. What do you think of the Oakland Raiders? Because I personally think they're going to beat the Dallas Cowboys in the Super Bowl this year.
All right, well, you just told everybody here in this pub that you're probably on drugs or something, because the Oakland Raiders are big pretenders, and I'll tell you why. The Raiders look good early in the year. They rolled up a 6-1 run. They're 7-2 right now. They were 6-1 a couple weeks ago, and they were going into a Monday night game at Mile High Stadium. And, of course, their loss came to the Kansas City Chiefs, as I see the Chiefs fan has got his hands up. They were 6-1 going into Mile High Stadium. Everybody was talking about, you know, the revival, you know, the return to Oakland and whatnot. And my apartment mate, Seth, who I will never let hear the end of, was talking some trash to me earlier that day, how the Cowboys were going to lose to the Raiders on November 19th, how the Raiders were going to go on and win the Super Bowl. And then what happened was Oakland put up a donut at Mile High Stadium, and the Broncos really are a mediocre team, and to get shut out like that on national television really is an embarrassment. And really, I mean, the Raiders ran, they rolled up wins against the Jets and the Seahawks and the Eagles. I mean, these are mediocre teams. I mean, yeah, they're rolling up big points and whatnot, but, you know, the Jets and the Seahawks are completely unimpressive. You're living in a fantasy world if you think, you know, the Raiders can even compare to the Cowboys. So as far as the Oakland Raiders are concerned, they're big pretenders. Chiefs are going to win the AFC West.
Yeah, but let's remember Dan's pick for the AFC for the Super Bowl, the Cleveland Browns. Let's analyze that one for a few minutes, tough guy.
Let me make it official right here on this show that I have officially given up on the Cleveland Browns. They are completely embarrassing. They lost to the Oilers at home. They're down to 4-5 now. And you tell me who's going to go to the Super Bowl? What are you doing? You imitating me? Stop that. I'd like to see the Chiefs get in the Super Bowl, but quite frankly, I think the Pittsburgh Steelers are going to sneak in there now, and I'll tell you why. Because I'll tell you why in a second. Rod Woodson's out for the year with an injury. However, he could come back at the end of the season, and should the Steelers get in the playoffs, they could have him. And if they have him, you watch them sneak into Tempe, Arizona, because the Steelers should have been in the Super Bowl last year, but it came 3 yards short. Why do the Eagles still have the ball? What the hell's going on here? Are they driving for another field goal? Another field goal, maybe?
Wait a minute. Yeah. It is not Rod Woodson the reason why the Steelers are bad this year, okay? Neil O'Donnell got hurt.
Yeah, that's true.
Mike Tomczak, right, okay? Yeah. I mean, Rod Woodson is great. I don't know if he should have been on that all-time team.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
He's really good, you know? But he's just a cornerback, okay? Neil O'Donnell is the reason why the Steelers are pretty bad this year, all right? He's back now, and they look pretty good, right?
Yeah.
They got that overtime
win. The Steelers are decent, but Rod Woodson's the heart of that defense, and, you know, it really was a psychological, you know, letdown to have Woodson go out for the year like that, and I can't believe the Eagles still have the ball. Yeah, who are you kidding, baby? Don't even throw a flag. Don't even throw a flag.
Oh, and I'd like to address a little comment you made before, Dan, about Boomer Esiason. Not that I'm a big fan about Boomer. Sorry to interrupt you.
I mean, what about Boomer Esiason?
That, you know, for the quarterback rating, he's in the top 10 all time.
Is he really?
Yeah.
So is Kenny O.
Boomer Esiason's in the top 10 rated quarterbacks of all time?
Yeah.
You sure about that?
Oh, I'm sure. Right up there with, you know, Joe Montana.
I did not know
Dan Marino.
What do you got for me, Crazy Jets fan?
I want to issue a challenge on TV here. Crazy Jet fan versus the Cowboy fan in a game of quarterback. Right there to the right.
Whoa.
If Crazy Jet fan wins, the Jets get to take over the show for a week.
Yeah.
And if I lose, I'll do my segment naked.
Oh.
I got one thing to say to you. You got a quarter, baby? Let's go.
Wait.
Football trivia. Football trivia.
Yeah, but that's a little, yeah. You want to do it? What do you want? Miss Pac-Man or football trivia? Yeah. All right, football trivia, baby. Let's go. All right. Everybody's got, that's too bad. Maybe he'll get a Jet question. All right, I ask that nobody yell answers out from the audience because God knows he ain't going to know them, so. And y'all want to see him do his show naked.
So are you ready?
Quarters out of that. Let's pop it in there. All right, hold on a second. Roy's going to set us up.
This is better than Bud Bowl.
Seriously, though. Speaking of the Bud Bowl, the Cowboys fan's going to be having the biggest Super Bowl party in Binghamton University's history come January 28th. I'm going to cram about 100 people in my apartment up in Hillside. We're going to have all the cameras set up and everything. It's going to be a huge Super Bowl extravaganza, much like this. And I'm paying for all the food, so isn't that interesting? All right, we're trying to get set up here. We got to do football trivia.
Doing this for Jet fans everywhere.
This is for Jet fans.
And if you want to send Crazy Jet Fan a birthday card, care of BTV, birthday's Thursday, got to be 21.
Yeah, they get the...
send one down. I'd like to hear from you.
I'll go in that camera. All right. Crazy Jets fan celebrates his birthday on November 9th, this Thursday. He's going to turn 21. He's going to be down here getting tanked. And right now, he's going to get tanked at football trivia. And he's going to go naked on his show next week. Maybe we'll give you the Jets blanket to cover up your privates.
But maybe not.
I hope.
What a treat we're going to have.
All I know is I hope
the
Jets
fans take over the show.
I hope Spire's taping this at home. That's all I care.
I love you, Mom.
All right. Your mom's not watching. We ready?
Now, can we go here, Roy?
All right. Pop those quarters
in. Pop in the quarters, baby. All right, waiting to get a little trivia whiz.
Two credit. Touch a game. Touch a trivia whiz.
Is that right?
Yeah, touch trivia whiz. Two players.
Two players.
All right, you want football. Make sure you touch it. All right, football, and hit it again. Okay.
All right, two-player football. Here we go. Go ahead first.
All right, I'll go with player one. I'll bet half. Steelers won their first Super Bowl by defeating the Minnesota Vikings 16-6 on January 12, 1975 in New Orleans, baby. All right, who goes?
Me, player two.
Has not thrown at least 200 touchdown passes.
Okay. I'm going to go with Terry Bradshaw.
Incorrect. That answer would be Roman Gabriel, probably, but they probably won't give you that. I'm betting now, we get five questions? Is that what we got?
Yeah.
Five questions. I'm on question number two now. I'm going to play a conservative. Rookie who scored six TDs in one game. Oh, that's got to be Gale Sayers, baby. Gale Sayers. Oh, and I'm rolling up the big points, and Steve's clothes are coming off, baby. I can't wait.
All right.
All right, what do you got? You got 5,000. You can't bet at all because you'll be gone.
I'm going to go a quarter here. Play it safe.
Who won Super Bowl 10? Oh, I know this, baby. I know this, baby. You got to think about your history.
76.
And time is expired on the Jet fan. The Pittsburgh Steelers beat the Dallas Cowboys 21-17.
I know there's a time limit. What's up with
that? On January 18th, 1976 in the Orange Bowl.
Yo, you got to throw a question. I know
there's
a time
limit. Four times the bet. Here, let's go. I'm going to take half because you're going naked. What two running backs gave over 2,000 yards? You know it's O.J. Simpson and Eric Dickerson, baby. O.J. Simpson rushed for 2,003 yards in 1973. Dickerson topped out with 21 and change in 1985. And crazy Jets fans.
How many questions did you get? Five?
Yeah, you got to bet it all.
I'm going all, baby.
He's going
all
for
or
the
nothing.
Money.
An onside kick can be returned by anyone if it...
That's an easy question.
Goes
you got
beyond
it.
10 yards, and we're still in it, baby.
He's still in it, but he's got to hope I get one wrong. And what am I up to? This is question number four. Not yet. We want to make it a little dramatic. Youngest player elected to the Pro Football Hall of Fame.
Oh, he don't know it. He doesn't know it.
It's either Jim Ringo or Gale Sayers. I don't know if Jim Ringo... But could Gale Sayers be the answer twice? You bet your ass, baby. That's four in a row. Gale Sayers' injury cut his career short. And I'm up to, oh, I got to go.
We're going all again.
Oklahoma running back to win the Heisman Trophy. Oh, I know this one.
Shit. We're going
Billy Sims.
Sims
is the correct guess, baby. Let's see what we got here. Well,
what's the score here? I can't even. Oh, it's not.
I'm up 240,000 points on you.
Bet it all. Make it interesting.
You know what? I'm gonna make it interesting, because this is for all the money, baby. Holds the NFL record for the longest field goal, and you know that's Tom Dempsey, baby, on November 8th, 1970, 63 yards against the Detroit Lions. 5 for 5, baby, I'm the man, and crazy Jets fans going naked next week. How about that, baby? And crazy Jets fans gonna be naked next week on the show. He got annihilated.
Next week, 1 week.
2 million
week.
Zero.
But I got the last three right.
Did you get the last one right?
Yeah.
All right, so you lost about.
Wanna go double or nothing?
Forget double or nothing. Oh, you go wink. Sit down.
You know, you might as well.
All right, these are my friends Jen and Laura, and they came down to the show to support me, and
they actually
paid, poor girls, but I feel bad that they did, and give me a kiss and the shirt's yours. Let's go. All right, 1, 2, 3. Aw, these are my apartment mates. And I'm glad they came down here. All right.
Dan.
All right. That's
in your pants.
Even in my pants. You got to get brave girls to come down here and sit on zebra pants. Look at Emmett Smith turning the corner for that first down. All right, you got your T-shirt. Everybody's happy. Crazy Jets fans going naked next week, baby. How much fun's that going to be? I can't wait. I know it's a nice shirt. If you'd have sat on my lap and kissed me, I'd have given it to you. Forget it. Now, you're going naked next week. So everybody's wrapping it up here right now. The Cowboys are going on to their 8th win of the season. They'll be 8-1. And we want to thank everybody for coming down here to the pub, watching a little Monday Night Football. Emmett Smith's not hurt. Who are you kidding over there? Bye-bye, Laura. Thank everybody for coming down to the pub, getting the free wings and whatnot. Thank my guests, James and Anthony. Anthony cut out a little while ago. Crazy Jets fans, naked next week. And we'll see you next week on the Cowboys Fan, baby. Peace.
I should have been a cowboy. I should have learned to rope and ride. Wearing my six-shooter, riding my pony on a cat and drive. Stealing a young girl's heart. Just like I should have been a cow.